It's a four-corner state famous for the open desert and a culture with deep Spanish and Native American roots.
The best way to explore the land of enchantment is in a classic beauty like this pretty baby.
New Mexico, home to a piece of the famous Route 66, the original highway connecting the Midwest to the West Coast.
Route 66 is one of the country's original highways. For anyone who drives a car, it symbolizes freedom, mobility.
On the road, we meet Quenisha Myers of Q's Cakes and Sweets Boutique.
I've been baking since I was about 10 or 11 years old. Started with a recipe for chocolate chip cookies.
Quenisha turned that hobby into a business, but the pandemic forcing her to close her dream store.
I had to let my employees go initially. It was nerve-wracking and it was a little bit scary.
Now open at full capacity, Q's Cakes are back.
The great thing about New Mexico, especially Albuquerque, is that people here really want to support local businesses.
At Weems Gallery and Framing, you'll find art you might have seen on TV.
Bowling, that's fun.
Yet even with its Hollywood roots, the gallery continues to support local artists.
We just made a decision to stick it through for the community. We support over 200 artists here, small businesses.
So it's not just you.
Oh, no, no. It's a large community here.
And at Weems, from sculptures to canvases, an important look at the culture of the land of enchantment.
Hollyhocks are just gorgeous.
Renowned Native American artist and former governor of Pohowake Pueblo, George Rivera, using his talent to share his native heritage.
There was nothing more impressive to me than being involved in the culture and trying to capture it and portray it with my work.
One of those art forms, traditional hoop dancing. Rivera and his wife creating the Lightning Boy Foundation in honor of their 8-year-old son, Tino, who passed away in 2016.
We created the Lightning Boy Foundation to teach young Native Americans hoop dancing. The results you get are just amazing.
The pandemic changing the way the foundation operates.
The pandemic put a halt to all of the performances that we were doing. As soon as we could, we started practicing again outside, little by little.
Those outdoor practices keeping the tradition alive. This is the longest aerial tram in North America, overlooking some of the most breathtaking urban peaks in the entire country.
We're ascending more than 10,000 feet into the Sandia Mountains outside of Albuquerque, with a panoramic view of more than 11,000 square miles.
The National Parks and Forests of New Mexico, a huge draw for the more than 38 million tourists who visit every year.
This pass here, it's called Arroyo Calabaza, and it's a dry riverbed. In New Mexico, you mostly have dry riverbeds.
George Malley of Santa Fe Mountain Adventures works to teach visitors about these majestic deserts.
What do you want people to take away?
The idea is, in fact, nature is something which speaks to any one of us. When you come here, we just feel happy.
So you want to put a smile on people's faces.
Exactly.